Because think about it, if these older women are still on the dating market trying to navigate dating and trying to learn how to date, who the hell are teaching young girls how to date? That is how we continue these generational cycles. The older women who are supposed to be teaching the younger ones are still learning. They're still clueless, like Boo Boo the Fool. No disrespect, but if you're over 40, let's say 40, if you're over 40 and you're asking questions like, oh, is that okay to friendzone him? Stop it.
I don't think it's really about them still learning. I think it's more about them being in competition and trying to do what they perceive younger women doing. And they're also out there giving bad advice because misery loves company and women are going to be jealous of each other. A lot of women don't want to see women doing better than them. They don't, you know, they have that competition type of thing going on all the time. It doesn't matter how old they are or how young they are. And really, in this modern time, 40 years old is rather young because a lot of 40-year-old women are very immature. This goes back generation to generation, at least 2 to 3 generations, where you have a lot of women teaching these bad tips to women in general. And all these younger women that you see running around doing all these things that they do is based on the advice that they got from these said older women. So I don't think that these women are still learning. I think that they're just more apt to give out bad advice out of jealousy and envy. Because you have to remember that a woman that is 40, a woman that is 50, she didn't have all this opportunity that a lot of these younger women have. So they're going to be jealous of that. They want the same amount of attention. They want to jump on TikTok or Instagram or Twitter or wherever they're going to be, or dating sites. They want to jump on those sites and get just as much attention as the younger women do. So odds are that they're going to give some bad advice. Even the advice that they followed before that doesn't work, they're still going to push that out there and say, hey, do this, don't do that. You know what I mean? All of this no contact and ghosting people and doing all this, these are all modern games. You see what I'm saying? Nothing about this is traditional. And another thing you need to think about, if there's a woman that's 40, 50 years old, why isn't she married? Why isn't she still married? Why did she leave her marriage that she had? Or why did she leave her long-term relationship? Because women always think that they can do better and they follow the narrative. See, the worst thing that women can do is follow other women when it comes to relationships, because usually they're not going to get the best advice. But women tend to not want to ask men anything. They don't want to ask men how they feel, what they want, you know, what makes them tick. They tend to always ask women, and other women know this. So if you're a woman and you're watching this video and you think just because another woman is smiling at you and telling you how beautiful you are and that you're a 10 and all this type of stuff, that she really has your best interests at heart, you have to understand that she doesn't usually. There's usually some kind of underlying factor, some kind of underlying thing that's pushing her to say that to you. A lot of times when women give other women advice or compliments rather, it's usually out of, oh, that's a nice dress. And then you get the side eye, and the woman that she's giving a compliment to doesn't see that, but other people in that situation can see. You know, if you study women long enough, you can read their behaviors and you can understand why they do and why they say certain things. So I think it's more about them just giving bad advice because they're jealous and they're envious and they want the same type of opportunity. They want the same type of attention. Because really, if you're a 40-year-old, 50-year-old woman and you don't have a husband, or you have a divorce or a breakup or something happened, you lost. So how is a loser going to give someone advice on being in a successful relationship when they couldn't even do it themselves? So I'm not saying don't listen to any advice that women give you, but be careful about the advice that you take in as something that's, you know, for your best interest, because a lot of times it's not.
You have the power to achieve anything you want. Don't let anything or anyone distract you from your goals. And remember, stay focused, stay strong, and stay positive. Make sure to like, subscribe, and share this video with those in need.